दिल दरिया समंदरों डूंगे, कौन दिला दिया जाने हु, विच हिन बेड़े विच हिन जेड़े, विच हिन मलाह मुहाने हु, 14 तबक दिले दे अंदर, जिथा इश्क तंबू वहीं ताने हु, फाजिल सट फजीलत बैठे, जदा दिल लगा ठिकाने हु।
चढ़ चन्ना ते कर रोशनाली, जिक्र कर दे तारे
Hazrat Sultan Bahu Rahmatullah Alayh, the king of Gnostics who has completely annihilated himself in God. Hazrat Sheikh Sultan Bahu Rahmatullah Alayh's sacred shrine is located in a village at the bank of River Chenab in Pakistan, which is named on his august name Mauzu Sultan Bahu Rahmatullah Alayh. His auspicious lineage links with Hazrat Ali, may Allah sanctify his face. So he has descended from Alvi Hashmi descent and from Awan tribe racially. His honorable father, Hazrat Behzad, may Allah bless him, had been very sedate, religious, hafiz, and a jurisconsult. He had been a dignitary during the Mughliya reign. His reverend mother, Hazrat Bibi Rasti, may Allah bless her, had been one among the accomplished saints. In spite of competent and innate saint, the Creator had destined Hazrat Sultan Al-Arifin for his exoteric and esoteric upbringing and external and intrinsic training to such a virtuous and immaculate woman who had enlightened his body and chaste heart in his childhood with the splendor God. His mother had been revealed esoterically before his birth that soon a Gnostic saint and an accomplished faqir who have been born from you, who would fill and enlighten the whole world with his light and secrets of Gnosis near the end of the time. Give him the noble name Bahu, because like his name, he would be with God. Hazrat Sultan Bahu, may Allah bless him, is exact exhibitor of the name Hu. In his books, he mentioned himself as Faqir Bahu, who has annihilated in his very essence, and everywhere describes his nearness and union, inhalation and immortality in Hu. In the name Bahu and Yahu, he narrates, sometimes in prose and sometimes in poem, strange hints, signs and hidden metaphors, and reveals strange secrets and sciences. According to knowledge of divining, the sum of the alphabets of his name Bahu is 14. Likewise, the moon turns full moon of the 14th date of lunar month, and human baby reaches its youth and puberty at the age of 14. This digit is the double of the 7 divine creations of the universe. By doubling 14, it becomes 28th of the lunar month and 28 alphabets of Arabic. The moon remained disappeared 2 days of the 30 days of lunar month and have not been computed, and the Arabic alphabets have 30 letters, out of them Hamza, Alif, Yazil, and La are considered one, and actual letters left are 28. Meaning, if the secrets and sciences of this sedate name have been counted, it would become a separate volume. Hazrat Sultan Al-Arifin, the king of Gnosis, like Hazrat Muhammad, peace be upon him, at the age of 63 years. He moved from this mortal world to the next immortal world and got united with God. His grave, in this time of soon and darkness, is powerful antidote and great cure for poisoned and dead hearts of the seekers of truth. Thousands of Gnosis who have been thirsty has quenched their thirst with his bountiful glance and countless dead hearts have become alive and awakened. Hazrat Faqir Noor Muhammad Sarwari Qadri, God bless him, being perfect exponent of the matchless, unparalleled and everlasting Faqir of Hazrat Sultan Al-Arifin, was his perfect representative. He used to write Faqir in the beginning of his name because he spent all his life in the earning of wealth of Faqir and swimming in his shoreless ocean. Faqir was his life and life's ideal. He used to write the word Sarwari Qadri because of the spiritual order of the path. His August birth took place in a little known remote town, Kalachi, in district Dera Ismail Khan, Pakistan in 1883. The auspicious name of his father was Haji Gul Muhammad, who was very sober and pious saint. He was pretty good in Arabic and Persian. He was confident about Faqir Noor Muhammad from the very beginning that he would emerge a perfect saint and would bring good name to the family. Genealogically, he is Pathan and Gandapur nationality wise, whereas Gandapur nation's lineage linked with both side noble Sayyid Mir Gesu Daraz, may God bless him, whose shrine is a rendezvous for all in Gulbara near Hasanabad in the state of Hyderabad, Dakkan, India. Hazrat Faqir Noor Muhammad Sarwari Qadri, may Allah bless him's excellence and great work of his life, is that the Faqir of Hazrat Sultan Al-Arifin, which had gone into the folds of books of a foreign language, Persian, had disappeared from the sight of world and which got concealed in the intricate terminology of Sufism had been rendered to the status of a fable and tale of past, was recovered from these curtains and was presented afresh with full grandeur before the world in easy and intelligible form. The world got astonished with the charming and captivating description. In Sarwari Qadri order, after Hazrat Sultan Bahu Rahmatullah Alayh, he is the first saint with publications and there is no one of his class and caliber in the whole order. His book Irfan is a masterpiece on the topic of Faqir, Sufism and spirituality. The Faqir, Hazrat Sultan Bahu had mentioned in his approximately 120 books, has been recited and summarized in Irfan. No other book in the world, in any language, is available on this topic that furnishes a parallel to Irfan, and this book has gained worldwide popularity, especially in every Muslim's home in South Africa and in the libraries of the world. Irfan is available. He spent his last 5 years of life in Faisalabad, Pakistan, and stayed there to his last breath. 3 days before departing to the next world, he kept conversing with his son Faqir Abdul Hamid Sarwari Qadri till late night, and during conversation said, "Abdul Hamid, it is an occurrence of long ago when you were a child that I dreamt having picked you up in my hands and infused all my enlightenment in you. In another dream, I saw as if I decapitated your head and transplanted my head on your neck. Your mother some days prior to giving birth dreamt a golden Quran in her lap. And therefore I got full confidence in your capability." October 16th, he made a will and appointed his son Faqir Abdul Hamid Sarwari Qadri as his spiritual successor. October 17th night, this son of Gnosis, whose beams had illuminated thousands of obscure minds, had set. His sacred anniversary has been celebrated on 16th, 17th and 18th of October every year, in which his followers from all over the world participate. His first successors, Faqir Abdul Hamid, being innate saint, is the author of many books on Sufism as well. Hazrat Faqir Noor Muhammad has published the Punjabi poems, meaning the collection of Punjabi Abayat, also known as Si Harfi of his Lord and preceptor, the King of Gnosis, Hazrat Sultan Bahu, in its true and real form with its Urdu translation. So that people and especially the followers of Hazrat Sultan Bahu would become familiar and acquainted with the actual theme of his Punjabi Abayat. Because in the previous Si Harfis, there were a lot of mistakes, and some other people's self-made and derived ones had also included in them, which not only being false, were against the Islamic law also. Such un-Islamic Abayat did not look like come out of the truth speaking tongue of Hazrat Sultan Larafin. And because of his un-Islamic nature, they were misleading for common people and worthless for the elites. Therefore, Hazrat Faqir Sahab picked up the pen for his noble cause and beneficial movement so that a correct and true collection of Abayat with its Urdu translation should be presented to the people who understand and have interest in Punjabi language. With the will of Allah, the tolerant and justice-oriented truth seeker would appreciate his effort, and being benefited and blessed by its study would remember Hazrat Faqir Sahab in their prayers. Hazrat Faqir Sahab had reading experience of Hazrat Sultanul Arifin's Persian books for 40 years, and by reading them he earned countless esoteric blessings and spiritual benefits, and that is why he could have distinguished and identified the true eloquent work of Sultan Bahu from plagiarists, and Sultan Bahu's blessed glance made it easy for him to understand and explain his Punjabi and Persian literature. Likewise, during his Sikh period, for a long time, being secluded at the old and new shrine of Hazrat Sultanul Arifin, he was blessed with the company of good dispositional and brightened saints and faqirs, and had golden moments to exchange views with them and to listen from them the true and correct Abayats. That is why Hazrat Faqir Sahab's collection of Abayats came out perfect and most beneficial. Also, it should be clear that these Abayats had revealed from the pearl-scattering tongue of Hazrat Sultanul Arifin when he was wandering from village to village in the search of preceptor in the early times of the path. Afterward, when he got united with his beloved, the God, and appointed at the level of command, he remained in the search of truth. Therefore, he says, "I remained in search of a preceptor for 30 years, and now I am in search of true seeker for many years, but could not see any true seeker courageous, determined, and efficient enough of being commanded, so that the countless curriculum I have been bestowed with give him the charity out of it and fulfill the duty of Allah upon me." Then after compiling and concealing his esoteric treasure in his Persian books, he called for open guidance. "I have opened the treasures of the Pinasi Gnosis. For the paupers, whoever has the wisdom and ability, come get it hurriedly." Keeping in view the services of Hazrat Faqir Noor Muhammad Rahmatullah Alayh, his grandson Faqir Harun Ahmad has established an academy in his name in Dera Ismail Khan, Pakistan. This academy translated the Punjabi Abayat and Rasala Ruhi Sharif, which is in Persian, in Hindi language, and distributed as gift among the Hindu and Sikh pilgrims who came to Hazrat Baba Guru Nanak's birthday in Pakistan. Hindu and Sikh pilgrims were blessed to see the translations of Punjabi Abayat and Persian Rasala Ruhi Sharif in Hindi.
Alif ala chambe di booti mere man vich murshid laayi hui nafi asbaat da pani mile as har rage har jaayi hui har ja booti mushk machaya ja phulante aayi hui murshid kamil har dam jeeve hazrat bahu jae e booti laayi hui
के मन में मस्तिष्क को मस्त करते हैं। इस बैत में हजरत सुल्तानुल अरफीन ने भक्त के हृदय को धरती तथा अल्लाह की पवित्रता संगता के बीच तथा
जिन्ना ने शब्द लिखे हैं दिल दरिया समुद्र डूंगे
कौन
दिला दिया जाने समझे जी। मन जिहड़ा है बंदे दा इहदे कोई शक नहीं कि दरिया तो डूंगा है
बिल्कुल ठीक,
मगर सानू कुछ लोगों ने मिल के आपस प्यार बिछड़ा पाता कि बिछड़ा क्यों गया, बिछड़ा नहीं पाना चाहिए सी, लेकिन बंदे दे विच कोई फर्क नहीं है। बंदे सारे जिहड़ा सच्चा है वो बंदा, जिहड़ा झूठा है गलता शैतान है।
बिल्कुल
जान ले तुझे अल्लाह ताला दोनों लोकों में आदेश दे, मैं हुब्बियत की हाँ तथा आयूद का खजाना लाहूत के भीतर छिपा था, अतः आलम मलकूत में मेरी इच्छा हुई कि मेरी जबरूत पहचानी जाए, अतः मैंने आलम नासूत में मखलूक को उत्पन्न किया, अर्थात हुब्बियत यथार्थता की आंखों को सत्रोत अर्थात यथार्थ प्रियतम ने दोनों लोगों से परे अपनी किब्रियाई कचहरी के भीतर अपने शासन के सिंहासन शोभित किया। इसके पवित्र अस्तित्व के रूप में रूप के भय से शस्त्रों बल्कि असंख्य बुद्धि के काफले नष्ट हो गए। सुभान अल्लाह।
बाकी साड़ी जी बोली है पंजाब की उधरली बोली तो इधरली बोली बल्कि सानू साबी बोली ना इधरली बोली बाली मिठी लगती है, जो ठीक है कि बोलते हैं ना तो कि अच्छा लगता है कि भी इन्होंने लोगों को किन्नी लियाकत है, किन्नी बोलन की तजीब है।
चंबे की बूटी मेरे मन में मुरछद लाई, नबी असबात का पानी मिली हर रंगी हर जाई, हर जा बूटी मुश्क पचाया जा बुलंद ते आई हूँ, मुर्शिद कामल हर दम जीवे हजरत बाहू जीए बूटी लाई।
This very act of Faqir Noor Muhammad's academy strengthened the friendship between Pakistan and India and is an act of peace between the two.
اول اللہ نور اپایا سب قدرت کے بندے एक नूर ते सब जग उपजे कौन भले कौन मंदे, अज आखां बारे शानू किदु कबरां विचू बोल, ते अज किताबे इश्क दा कोई अगला वरका फोल, इक रोई सी धी पंजाब दी तू लिख लिख मारी बैण, अज लखां धीयां रोंदियां तेनू वारे शानू कैण, उठ दर्द वदा दिया दर्दिया उठ तक अपना पंजाब, अज बेले लाशां बिछियां ते लहू दी भरी चनाब, धरती ते लहू वसिया कबरां पईयां चोण, प्रीत दियां शहजादियां अज विच मजारा रोण, अज सब कैदो बन गए हुसन इशक दे चोर, कित्थों ले आईए लबके अज वारे शाह इक होर।
हजरत फकीर साहब सरवरी कादरी, who is also the patron of Faqir Noor Muhammad Academy, said, if more resources would be available, we would present more books relating with spirituality in Urdu, Persian, Arabic, English and Hindi translations in Pakistan and other countries. The candle of truth and gnosis, which had been lit by Hazrat Sultan Bahu Rahmatullah Alayh, its light came to Hazrat Faqir Abdul Hamid Sarwari Qadri through Faqir Noor Muhammad Rahmatullah Alayh. When this light reached to Faqir Harun Ahmad Sarwari Qadri, after refracting into different languages, has started enlightening the hearts of the nations of the world.
Panje Mahal Panje Mahal Panjaon vich chonan वाकित वल धरिए हूँ।
ਮਾਰੇ ਆਪਨ ਜੇ ਮਹਿਰ ਪੰਜੇ ਪਟਵਾਰੇ ਹੌਸਲ ਕਿਤ ਵਲ ਭਰੀਏ।